various football leagues are continuing in Europe, just as we have some already ended. For instance, the French League and had to end
because the French people could no longer wait for the pandemic to end. That was why PSG was declared a champion. The German Bundesliga too produced her own champion. Indeed, they were the first team to keep playing when others could not really continue. Games have been on without fans, and the drama and excitement is continuing in some leagues, while some have ended, as I told you a moment ago. Clubs in the French league, for instance, are busy looking for better players against the next season. PSG, the champions, for example, are in negotiation with Kylian Mbappe. Will he remain there or he will not remain there? What about Brazilian talk about Neymar Jr.? You know, there are talks that he might be leaving, while others are saying that he has to stay. Of course, all these will be confirmed in the next couple of weeks before the restart. But it is not the same story in England, because the battles are on. They are not resting. They are indeed busy looking for how to really, really get a good representation for themselves. We all know that Liverpool are the champions already. Not long ago, they won their game and they are now on 92 points. The team that at least won the EPL title after a 30-year wait, comfortably on top of the league on 92 points, and nobody can stop them as far as that title ambition is concerned. They have been confirmed, but what has not been confirmed are those who will be representing England as far as continental football is concerned. First loss will be at stake. Indeed, Liverpool can comfortably lay claim to one of them. Ditto Manchester City. 69 points they're having. They'll be beating their opponents left, right, and center, including great victory over the champions Liverpool. After Liverpool were crowned champions not long ago too, Manchester City recorded a 5-0 away victory as far as the EPL is concerned. Chelsea currently are on third position, 60 points they are having. The boys of Frank Lampard are eager to be in Europe. Talk about the UEFA Champions League. Will they get it right? We can be sure that there will be plenty of pressure from Roman Abramovich and, of course, Chelsea's fans regarding return to the continent. Leicester City did themselves lots of good by being able to hold Arsenal to a 1-1 draw when both sides clashed at the Emirates. But they are presently on 59 points, and the drama talk about how to go to Europe will be continuing this weekend. Manchester United too are struggling. The Red Devils have been having a good outing since they returned from the pandemic break, and their fans too will also be hoping that they consolidate on their 55 points they currently have. While Wolves had lost at home to visiting Arsenal, have been really, really red-eyed since that outing, and they also be fighting for the ticket. Talk about how to be in the continent. They're a bit far from it, but the football were told nothing is impossible. Same goes to Mikel Arteta handled London Gunners Arsenal. In fact, they are also red-eyed after their inability to defeat Leicester in a game they dominated very well most of the first half, but unfortunately they could not win. No thanks to Nketiah's red card, and of course a drop of gas by the Gunners. So they picked just 1 point in that encounter. Tottenham Hotspur under Jose Mourinho is presently on 48 points, and they are having the same number of points with Sheffield United. But the battle to get the ticket will also be very, very tense among them. Equally, they want to be there as far as continental football is concerned. But interestingly, just four teams will make it to the continent. Talk about the UEFA Champions League. Of course, there's still opportunity of Europa is seen as a second-class championship. The drama will be continuing this weekend. For instance, Bournemouth will be taking on Leicester City, and there's also Tottenham set to take on Arsenal. That is a Sunday super clash. call it a super clash because Mikel Arteta for Arsenal and of course Jose Mourinho are under pressure to deliver. Both of them want a result, and it might not be likely for particularly Arsenal. But of course, this one moment they have to really make a mark. They want to convince their fans that they remain as good as those good years or you know yesteryears. So the drama will indeed be continuing. And we tell you too that some of our teams will also be in action this weekend. There's going to be Bournemouth against Leicester. Aston Villa will take on Crystal Palace. While Wolves will be taking on Everton in another encounter. We just hope our own Nigerian star, talk about Iwobi, Alex Iwobi, who got injured not too long ago, might just be back to help Everton that is handled by Carlo Ancelotti. But for teams like Crystal Palace, Brighton, West Ham, and not forgetting Bournemouth, they are really under pressure because the relegation pressure, talk about threat of being relegated, is knocking at the moment. Nobody really wants to be eliminated or dropped from such an enviable height. Talk about the English Premiership, but that is what makes it interesting. Yeah. Some will win, some will celebrate, while some will always cry at the end of the day. You can be sure it's bound to be smoky, it's bound to be interesting when the EPL and indeed some other leagues, including the Italian Serie A, where Juventus will also be in action, will be really be talk of the town as far as the weekend is concerned. From Lagos, I'm Raymond Akbarwere for News Express Nigeria Television.